Post-traumatic disorder is a disorder which is similar to anxiety and depression disorders. But the main reason here is being exposed to a traumatic event that has shaken the sense of security, such as exposure to death because of a car accident, war, severe illness, or severe injury. Exposure to sexual violence, such as rape or sexual harassment. Exposure to kidnapping or taken as a hostage. Being subjected to terror attacks, torture, political imprisonment, war captivity, and natural disasters. Man-made disasters such as wars have more psychological impacts than natural disasters. Experiencing the traumatic event can be either directly or indirectly. Indirectly by witnessing it occurring to others or knowing it has occurred to someone close, a family member or a friend. Those who are repeatedly exposed to traumatic events at their work, such as police officers, firefighters, rescue workers, soldiers, and physicians, the probability of having the disorder is high among them. The reason to have the disorder is that when we are exposed to any danger, our brain becomes alarmed and makes the body to secrete fight and flight hormones, which help us to survive. When we survive, the body goes back to its normal state. But in the case of this disorder, the brain keeps in the alarmed state and is unable to go back to normal. Some people are more susceptible to the disorder more than others. Two persons are exposed to the same traumatic event, one gets the disorder and the other one doesn't. The reason is biological, which means their genes, and environmental, which means the way they were brought up. The environmental factors which make one susceptible to have the disorder are discordance in family relationships, weak relationship with the parents or relatives, psychological problems in one of the parents, controlling parents, being brought up in extreme poverty. Symptoms of post-traumatic stress disorder appears within 1 to 6 months from the traumatic event. The intensity of symptoms differs from one person to another. The first symptom is having flashbacks of the event over and over again. The second symptom is having nightmares about the event. The third symptom is avoiding anything that reminds the person of the traumatic event. Symptom number 4 is losing memory regarding important details of the event. Symptom number 5 is acting as if the event is recurring to the point that they lose awareness of their surroundings. Symptom number 6, there is dramatic changes in the mood. The person feels they are not the same person anymore. Irritable behavior and angry outbursts with little or no provocation. Anger is directed towards people or objects. Pessimism and negative thoughts about oneself, life, and people. Feeling guilty and feeling distrust in life and people. And feeling that the world is a dangerous place. Continuous feeling of fear and sleep disturbance, such as difficulty falling or staying asleep. All these make some resort to drugs and alcohol to ease the pain. Treatment of post-traumatic stress disorder is a medical treatment by antidepressants, which increase the level of serotonin and noradrenaline. These hormones improve our mood. Psychological treatment is through correcting the cognitive distortions and negative thoughts and replacing them with positive thoughts. There is also another psychological treatment, which is treatment by narrative writing, in which the patient writes about the traumatic event with all its painful details and their feelings, over and over again, until the patient becomes desensitized and the event is no more painful for them.